Good afternoon. I'm Mark Bodditcher, Hardin County OSU Extension Educator, and today we're coming to you from the southwestern corner of Hardin County in the Scioto Marsh. And one of the things that this particular area is famous for are the soils. This soil that we have this sample dug up today is a roundhead series muck. As you can tell, it's very dark. It's very high in organic material. It has a lot of nitrogen in the soil and a lot of carbon in the soil. It's very poorly drained though. So on some years and when it's wet, it can be a detriment. But when you have a year with normal rainfall, the soil can be very productive. This particular field, if I remember the soil test that came back on it, was 5.3 on the pH scale. However, we'll have organic material anywhere in the roundhead series, anywhere in some areas of around 13%. Other areas, it may be in the 30s, and then some pockets as high as over 50% organic material. So as you can imagine, it's very productive soil, grows an excellent corn crop and other types of crops that can be planted in this particular soil type. Good afternoon. I'm coming to you today from a field in the northeastern corner of Hardin County. This happens to be a mineral soil in this particular corn field. This is a field where we had one of our nitrogen rate plots. Because it is a mineral soil, that in most Ohio soils, we're talking about organic matter that is less than 5%, and this has 1.8% organic matter in it. And this particular soil, it is somewhat poorly drained, and that is a result of the clay content in this particular series, which is usually 35 to 45% clay. If we have a good fertility program in place and we put the correct amount of starter fertilizer in this field along with good side dress application, we can get some respectable yields out of this particular type of soil.
Nitrogen rates applied to corn have changed over the years. Originally, when the tri-state fertilizer recommendations were released in Ohio, 1.2 pounds of nitrogen was recommended to produce a bushel of corn. Later, that number was reduced to 0.8 pounds of nitrogen, and today that number can be closer to 0.6 pounds of nitrogen to produce a bushel of corn, depending on soil types, mineralization, organic matter, and other factors. Corn hybrids today have more starch and less protein compared to hybrids grown 20 years ago. More efficient use of nitrogen can be accomplished by reducing risk of loss, varying application times, and use of modern sampling and application methods. This research compares 3 years of nitrogen rate trials in mineral soils to 3 years of nitrogen rate trials in muck soils with high organic matter content. 5 different side dress rates are compared with 3 replications in each trial over a period of 3 years in both a mineral soil field and a muck soil field. The results of these studies over 3 years show the best economic side dress rate in the trials mineral soils to be 150 pounds per acre with 32 pounds of starter nitrogen. The best side dress rate in these trials muck soils over 3 years show the best economic rate to be 100 pounds per acre with no starter nitrogen. Although additional nitrogen can increase corn yields, Ohio corn producers are moving towards using the best economic rate as an answer to tighter budgets and environmental concerns. The maximum return to nitrogen method is being recommended in the state with a new update of the tri-state fertilizer recommendations. On-farm research such as these trials provide evidence of the results of this method for farmers to consider when managing their nitrogen dollars.